Welcome back to another UNO Learning Academy tutorial video. In this episode of the demonstration series, we would like to demo the operational activities of a four-thread overlocker, also known as a mock or a mock safety. In this demo, we are using the Kingstar EX7470-D. This machine is suitable for seaming on stretchy type fabrics, lycras, knits, sportswear, etc. The unique features of this EX series is that this machine is an ultra high speed overlock. Here you are achieving speeds of up to 6,000 stitches a minute. Also unique to this machine is the electronic features of this machine. So we're going to take a few moments to have a look at the control panel on this machine so that we can see what special features we have about this Kingstar EX7470-D. Some of the special features of this machine, being an ultra high speed machine, it has the built-in direct drive motor with a Vortex air cooling system. It has a USB port for programming purposes. It has the user-friendly interface with LCD screen. It has all of the standard features you know about. If you come around to the back here, it has the optional extra of a waist suction, electro-pneumatic waist suction. It has the electric solenoid chain cutter. It also has the electric solenoid foot lift mechanism. So if we look at the interface, I'm just going to talk us through the buttons quickly. So on top here is the P. The P is for programming. So let's say you wanted to go and adjust a setting in the foot lift mechanism. We can move through the programs on the plus sign. So P6, I see it says auto foot lift. You can switch it on or off over there.
Start speed mode.
There you can set the speed mode. Number 8 is, you can adjust all of these settings, but guys, these are mainly factory settings. Okay, so it tells me now that I've set the speed to a maximum of 3000. You can adjust that later on when we get to that button.
The working LED light.
You can adjust the density of the light that's on the machine over here. Okay?
Semi-auto continue sewing. Semi-auto constant sewing. Front release foot presser lift. Foot control cutting line.
Guys, etc, etc, etc.
Manual mode.
So I've went back to the mode that we are in right now. This is obviously moving the up and the increasing the values on the plus and minus, and this is moving the cursor on the sensor from left to right. Guys, the next button at the bottom over here is going to be for setting the density of the fabric that you are working with when you're automatic mode. So I'm not going to work through those percentages now. It tells me I'm working on a thick fabric, a normal fabric, a thin fabric, a mesh, etc, etc, etc. Okay, so it's now set up for a thin fabric. Let's go to this button over here. The next button there is increasing the speed of my machine.
The max speed.
So I can adjust my speed up and down as I want to here by the plus button. Okay, so there I've now set it to 4,000 stitches a minute. I'm going to set the machine. This one over here is going to move me through the modes of sewing. Manual sewing, if you're just using it as a normal overlock, you can use it as for free sewing. They call it semi-automatic. And then we have the automatic feature. So I'm going to do the automatic feature. Okay, this one over here we said is increase the speed. Guys, this button over here is
thread tension release mode.
This is when you are using, let's say, a back latch mechanism, you're going to use this or not. For now, we are leaving that feature off. Okay,
thread tension release.
Next, there we can set the needle up or down. So, whenever we stop sewing, we can choose whether we want our needle up or down. In this case, we've chosen up. There, I can adjust the density of the LED. I can adjust the density over there. Guys, we put it on 3. You can choose. You've got a few selections. This one over here is for our, if we're going to use our optional
suction mode.
If you add the feature of when you finish trimming to suck the dirt away, and while you're operating, you can use the side waste, the cutting away waste can fall into the waste suction mechanism. There you can either switch the
cutting line mode.
You can either switch the trimmer off or on. It's got the guillotine type trimmer. You can switch it on or off. And there it's got the automatic foot lift mode. You can tell the machine, I only want to lift the foot in front. I want to lift the foot front and back. I want to switch it off. Whatever you want to do, you set that setting. Okay, guys, so that's the keypad. You can work through these things. You'll get used to that eventually. You may want to set it in automatic mode. You may set it in
operate mode.
I am going to
operate mode.
Go to
manual mode.
Free sewing. Let's go to semi-automatic. So guys, remember I said it's in semi-automatic mode now. Okay, so semi-automatic mode will let me lift the foot as I approach. You can set that timing of how long you want the foot to stay up for. So if I can also back heel and my foot will lift, okay? So I can put it in free mode, I can back heel and lift my foot. I can put it in semi-automatic mode and it will lift itself. So I'm not gonna use the pedal now, I'm gonna introduce my work. So you've got a sensor here. There's sensors on the machine to tell the machine, oh, we got fabric here. Let's lift the foot up. I can lift my foot manual. And guys, you're gonna see a guillotine's gonna chop there now. So you can set how many stitches you want the machine to count and the guillotine will kick in, okay? We're gonna run the machine to the end. And if you look here very closely, I'm gonna go slowly. And the guillotine chopped, the foot lift up, and the foot remained up. So it will go down again. You can set that timing. Guys, once you've got your setting in your machine, you don't need to adjust it again. Okay? So there, and as I come to the end of my sewing, my foot goes up, my guillotine kicked in, and that's done. So guys, I'm gonna push my mode. The voice prompt indicated I'm on auto mode. So what that will do now, if you look at my work, I'm going to do a short little seam here, or a short little seam down my pocket. I'm closing a pocket here. So what it will do is, I said there's a sensor there. The machine will see the work. I will not put my foot on the pedal. The foot will lift. It will start sewing. And as it comes to the end, the chopper will kick in and the foot will lift up. So let me do that again for you. You can put that on the timer as to how long you want the foot to stay up. You introduce the work. And the chopper will kick in. You will see, guys, I done nothing. I didn't put my foot on the pedal. I didn't lift the foot. I didn't do that. I didn't put the chopper in. Remember, you can also push the chopper here. So if you just look there closely, there's a guillotine chopping in every time. There's a guillotine chopping the thread off. So you don't have long, long chains of thread. Okay, let me go again. So I'm not gonna put my foot on the pedal. I'm not gonna lift the foot. I'm not gonna do anything. I'm just introducing the work because I'm doing a small little run on the pocket and my machine starts sewing and I've got a clean cut, okay? Guys, that's the automatic features on the machine. You can take that out. You can just set it for front chop, back chop, intermittent sucking. You can do all kinds of setting on the machine. The main purpose of this machine is to speed up the cycle time in your production. So all of that, what is it doing for you? It's speeding up your cycle time. So where your job normally took you 45 seconds with your automatic features, with your guillotine, with your chop, it's saving you thread, it's saving you air, it's saving you electricity, it's saving you time, it's all around saving. So invest in capital equipment. Not in labor, you want to avoid that, invest in capital equipment. So guys, remember I always talk about maintenance. This will include topping up your oil, keeping your machine clean, have a monthly program around that. clean around your work areas, clean around your motor. And remember, you can also log into our assembly series, our threading series, our accessory series, and application series or troubleshooting. Guys, please watch this space for our academic and practical online and in-person upcoming training courses. Thank you for joining us on this educational journey on our video channel. Please hit the subscribe and the like buttons below on the UNO Learning Academy YouTube channel and continue to grow and sow into the industry's technology and future. Thank you.